إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله، يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام، إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. أما بعد، فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله، وأحسن الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، وكل محدثة بدعة، وكل بدعة ضلالة، وكل ضلالة في النار. أما بعد، وعن جرير بن عبد الله رضي الله عنه قال: قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم: من لا يرحم الناس لا يرحمه الله. On the authority of جرير بن عبد الله رضي الله عنه, he said that the Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم said, whoever does not have mercy upon the people, then Allah does not have mercy upon him. متفق عليه. Sheikh Abd al-Rahman ibn Nasir al-Sa'di rahimahullah commented on this hadith saying, the literal wording of the hadith indicates that the one who does not have mercy to the people, then Allah does not have mercy upon him. The understanding of the hadith is that whoever has mercy upon the people, then Allah has mercy upon him. Just like the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said in another hadith, الرَّاحِمُونَ يَرْحَمُهُمُ الرَّحْمَنِ ارْحَمُوا مَنْ فِي الْأَرْضِ يَرْحَمُكُمْ مَنْ فِي السَّمَاءِ. Just like the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam mentioned in another hadith, الرَّحْمَنِ, the most merciful, has mercy upon the merciful people. So have mercy upon those on the earth, and the one above the skies will have mercy upon you. Therefore, the mercy of the slave of Allah has, the mercy that the slave of Allah has for the creation is from the greatest means by which the mercy of Allah is acquired. From the effects of that mercy is goodness in this dunya and goodness in the hereafter. From the greatest means of Allah's mercy being blocked and prevented is if the slave of Allah does not have mercy upon the creation. The slave of Allah is in great need and dire want of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's mercy. He cannot do without it even for the blinking of an eye. And he cannot do without the mercy due to what it contains of blessings and repelling of punishment from the mercy and the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When a person wants the mercy of Allah to continue and increase, then he needs to implement all of the means by which the mercy of Allah is obtained. All of the means are combined in the saying of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, إِنَّ رَحْمَةَ اللَّهِ قَرِيبٌ مِّنَ الْمُحْسِنِينَ. Indeed, the mercy of Allah is near to the doers of good. So this verse, it shows us that those who do good receive Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's mercy. There are two types of mercy that the slave of Allah has. The first type is natural mercy. Allah has granted some of His slaves this mercy. He placed compassion, mercy and sympathy in their hearts for the creation. These slaves of Allah carry out what they are capable of in benefiting the people and do so according to their capabilities. They are praised and rewarded for what they do, and they are excused for that which they fall short in. And perhaps Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wrote a reward for them due to their truthful intentions, even though their strength was not enough to carry out those actions. The second type is the mercy that a slave of Allah acquires by following every path and means in order to characterize his heart with that mercy. The slave of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows that this description is from the most noble and most complete of manners and behaviors. He strives to characterize himself with it, and he is aware of the reward that Allah has prepared for being merciful and what he loses if he is prohibited from that reward. He desires excellence from his Lord, and he strives with all the different means to acquire that excellence. The effect of this mercy, which is in the heart, become evident upon the limbs, and the tongue is striving to do good, righteousness, and relaying benefits to the people, and to discontinue harm, and being compelling and offensive to the people. بسم الله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله. The sign that shows the presence of mercy in the heart of the slave of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is that he loves the goodness to reach all of the creation generally and specifically to the Muslims, and he dislikes that evil and harm reaches them. Likewise, having mercy upon young children and slaves and making them happy is also from being merciful. As for not having concern for them and not having gentleness with them, then this is from coarseness, harshness and cruelty. Just like some of the coarseness of the Bedouins when they saw the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam and his companions kissing their younger children, one of the Bedouins said, I have 10 children and I have never kissed any of them. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam said to him, أَوَ أَمْلِكُ لَكَ شَيْئًا أَن نَزَعَ اللَّهُ مِنْ قَلْبِكَ الرَّحْمَةِ. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam replied to the Bedouin man who said, I have 10 children and I've never kissed them. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, how can I hold something for you when Allah has removed mercy from your heart? Also, an example of being merciful is the mercy that the prostitute woman had when she gave water to the dog to drink. He was going to eat dirt due to his extreme thirst, and Allah forgave her due to that mercy. The opposite of the example is how a woman was punished due to her tying up a cat. She did not feed her or give her drink, nor did she leave her to eat from the leftovers of the earth until the cat died. So ikhwan, strive your utmost to try and be merciful to people. And it starts from being merciful also to your wives and your children. It's ajeeb that we live in a time where some people, especially certain individuals, they show mercy to other people, and when they go to their workplace, but within their house they are the most cruel people, and they shout and they're harsh to their families. This is in opposition to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam's advice. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam encouraged even being merciful to animals, let alone those in your household. هذا وصلى الله على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. واقم الصلاة.